Greg Marcus. This is Chris. He's our customer liaison person and jack of all trades at RhinoTech. So he's going to help me out a little bit with this video today. We're going to be talking about two different items. One is our RhinoMite two-part frame adhesive. This is RMA 3000. This comes in an amber, almost clear color, but you can also get it in a red version if you so desire. Extremely versatile, easy to use product. We're also going to be talking about our Model 300 stretcher, which is a tabletop model for stretching rigid frames. It's a bar system. Let's take a little bit closer look at it. Okay, with this stretcher, as you can see hopefully in this video, is that we have locking bars that are on all four sides. These are set up so that they come in almost about to the corner of your frame, the outside dimension. We have a dual cylinder set on each side. It has a 3-inch stroke. We have tilted mounting brackets. So what that's going to do is, as we're pulling in on the mesh, we're going to have these so that they hopefully won't lift up on us. But to be careful with this, a lot of times we chain them down anyways, just to be on the safe side. We have our locking bars, which is how we put the mesh in. And Chris is going to load this up for us, and we're going to stretch it out and glue it up. Okay, we already had this side locked in, as you can see. So what he's going to do is draw back over it a little bit, you know, pull in the fabric, and then lock it down in place. So we're going to draw it over and snap it down. Okay, we're using a compressed air, obviously, out of our compressor, and we're going to have that and take it. So we have a dual pulling mechanism. He has one control that's pulling this way, and then one that's pulling the opposite direction. He's going to use his tension meter. What we want to do is get somewhere in the neighborhood between 23 and 25 newtons in this particular case. Actually, Chris, what mesh count are we using
here? We're using 110 mesh.
Okay. Keep in mind, the procedure is the same if it's 110, 160, 305. It's looking pretty good. Good. In a lot of cases, what we like to do is then let it sit for a little bit, check it again, just to make sure that we haven't lost any tension. At the same time, I might add, when we're pulling in, these are freestanding on the bed itself, so they're pushing in, they're pre-bowing this frame, so that when we actually cut it out of the mesh, it's going to pop back in place, so we maintain that tension that we had it set to originally. I guess we can actually move into the actual gluing, right?
We can.
Okay, let's do it.
All right.
Okay, again, we're using RhinoMite two-part catalyst system. Comes in a real clear amberish color or a red color. So he's taken a little squeeze bottle, puts a bead down each side, and then spreads it, making sure that it's penetrating through the mesh and bonding securely onto the frame itself. The one thing that's nice about this product is we actually also make it in three different viscosities. There's a 15, a 17, and a 19% solids base. You're going to want to use the thicker material, specifically when you're doing coarser meshes, and the thinner material when you really get up in those high mesh counts, that 390, 420 and higher. That way we make sure that we've penetrated through it. You'll notice that we have two parts to this. We have our glue and we have a catalyst. So we mix that prior. The catalyst, actually, the primary function of that is so that it gives us good solvent resistance. Okay, that's how simple this is. Chris just went around the frame, put a bead, spread it out. Now we have to let it dry. With this particular product, you're looking at approximately 8 to 12 minutes, but that will depend a lot on where you are, the temperature, the humidity level, and so forth. When you do come back and you start to check it though, if you think it's dry, if you touch it and it feels really cold, let it sit a couple of more minutes. After that, you can release the pressure, cut off the excess mesh, and you're ready to go. It's that absolutely simple. Anyone with this piece of equipment, the Model 300 bar stretching system, and a gallon of RhinoMite can go to town, do all their screens in-house if they want, or restretching after you've already brought in a load of them, type of thing. So give us a like on our YouTube channel. Check out RhinoTech, rhinotechinc.com, and you'll know where to find us.